Welcome back to Cradle. So I basically had to start from the beginning and do everything over, which isn't that big of a deal because I didn't really do much in the last game other than read a bunch of stuff on the walls, because this game doesn't have manual saves. I guess it saves at checkpoints, and I didn't do anything worthy of saving at a checkpoint. So I jumped back in, I redid everything that I did before, like took the couple items off of there, stuck it inside her chest, grabbed the knife, the lighter, I filled up the cup of water, I lit the fire here, and I think that's everything I did. So basically, I'm essentially where I was before. So let's continue on. Hopefully, I actually do something worthy of saving this time. Alright, so let's take a look around before I go outside. Garlic? I think I've read most of the things. Postcard with a view of the city. Sign below reads, Geneva's happy to receive guests with any quotients. Mobile transfer instructor. Yeah, I've read this before. Tabaha, I got fat and now I smell bad. Turn off your nose and don't look at me. I didn't say goodbye to Ongots. I waited for him all day, but he didn't return. Please feed him and change him. Who's Ongots? Lest he gets sick. Follow this recipe. Heat the red pot, add a glass of water, add a few cut plum olive fruits. There are plenty of them by the lake. Add dried root, but don't forget to grind it. Add salt and water, and the water will turn orange. Return the salt jar to its place. Right of the pepper, as Grandpa Batgen instructed. Cook until it's done. Ongots will show up as soon as he smells the food. You could sell all the stuff you like and toss the body in the river. I won't be coming back. Wow. Okay. Oh, game saved. See? All I had to do is read this piece of paper that was right in front of my face where I woke up. I think I read absolutely everything in this game outside of the piece of paper that was right in front of my face where I woke up. I'm a dumbass. Okay, so heat the red pot, add a glass of water. Okay, I have a glass of water. Red pot was here, I think. Yeah. Alright, so red pot. Glass of water. Alright. I probably don't need the glass anymore. I set it down somewhere where I won't drop it. Let me set it down on this table here. Right about here. It's probably gonna fall, isn't it? Oh, I got it on the edge of the table. Cool. I wish you could like extend your arm. I hate being so messy. Alright, so I need those plum olive fruits, right? Cut plum olive fruits. Plenty of them by the lake. So I gotta go outside for this. I have a knife, so I can cut them. I'm probably gonna bring them back here to cut them. I suppose I can cut them out there. Alright, outside we go. Close the door. This. Clothesline. What are these things? Oh, these are roots. Did it say something about dried roots? And they've been hanging here drying. And I need to grind them, right? Well, I'll look at the instructions later. Okay. How much room do I have in my inventory? 3 spots. Okay. Take 2 of those. Alright, so that looks like the lake down there. Or that's a river. Does it mean this as a lake? That's like a little bog at most. That's definitely not a lake, but like it could just be meaning lake for any small non-moving body of water. I certainly wouldn't qualify this as a lake. Those red fruit on the tree look edible. I'll try and find something to use to knock them down. What red fruit on the tree? Which tree? Tree. The trees. Oh, okay, yeah, right there. I bet those are the plum olive fruits. Mortar and pestle must be somewhere in the crockery. Oh, because I picked up the root. Okay. Can I pick up this branch? I can. Oh, I bet I can throw this branch at the fruits. That was a very good throw. Different angle here, so I don't hit the tree itself. Bang! There we go. Where did that drop? There we go. Now it said fruits, plural. I think I need more than one. How many inventory slots do I got? I have two more open. I might as well fill up my inventory with them. I don't know if I need one or two or three or 12, but I'll take as many as I can carry right now. That. All right. Probably don't need to take the branch with me. I can always come back for it. Alright. Kinda wish there was a faster movement speed than this. This is as fast as I can go. This is walking, I guess, and this is running. But this game kinda chill and relax, so maybe allowing me to move faster than this wouldn't really fit with the theme. I don't know. Alright. Back into my yurt I go. Yeah, close the door behind me because I'm not a barbarian. Alright. Now, let's see. So I need to cut these. Plop these down on this table. It's probably the best surface I have to use as a cutting board, I think. Kitchen counter would probably be better, an actual cutting board, but I don't have a lot of room on those. Alright. That didn't work. Let's try this again. That's as far as I can go, right? Ah, there we go. Nice. Alright, so I plopped this in here. Mm-hmm. That looks tasty. Alright, let's grab another one. It up. That. Pop it in there. That. Pop it in there. Oh, it says new task added. So that's probably telling me that I've put enough in there. But for the heck of it, let's see if I can put more in. Two was probably enough. Most likely. Nope, yeah, that's right. This doesn't do anything. Okay. Leave that then. I need to just toss it on the ground like that. Put it on the table. Damn it. Cooperate, damn you. Alright, screw it. It's going to be on the ground. Alright. Next step. Add dried root, but don't forget to grind it. And said something about mortar and pestle being in the crockery. So, crockery. It's got to be here, right? Oh. What's that? That looks like a possibly a pestle. Yeah, that's probably a pestle, isn't it? What are these? Smells like vinegar. Looks like oil. A dark, murky liquid. Reeks of alcohol. And that's probably the mortar there. Okay. So let's see. Put the mortar down. Get this fruit out of the way. Okay. Let's see. I Take the root, I put it in there. I put more than one. I can. Okay. Take the pestle. Probably won't need this anymore. Plop this down. Oh, I even stayed upright. Look at that. I couldn't do that again if I tried. Take this. Use that in there. Sure can. Alright. Add salt and the water will turn orange. Return the salt jar to its place, right of the pepper, as Grandma Batchin instructed. These are probably the spices. It's a good thing when I restarted, I didn't take all of these because they're still in order. So right of the pepper, which one's the pepper? Is this more tea? I'm going tea. The brew didn't turn out well. I mixed up the spices again. Eye drops don't seem to be helping. I still can't make out the text. You and me both. Well, I could see the text, but I can't read it because, you know, I don't read Mongolian. Please arrange the jars in the same order. Pepper, salt, cinnamon, curry, sugar. I don't remember the order now, and with heaven's help, I won't mix it up again. Pepper, salt. Okay, so it'll be the second one. This one. Aha! What's this card? Ginger, garlic, Sichuan pepper. The pack is empty. Empty matchbox. Alright, I'll put this back. I have to put it. This will just drop it. If I throw it, can I get it back in there? Well, yeah, but I knocked a different one over. Hopefully I don't need to use these spices anymore. Pepper, salt, this was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I do, I gotta remember this was the second one, this was the third one. Alright. Alright, so I got this stew. Oh, that looks good. So, what now? Cook it until it's done. Angots will show up as soon as he smells the food. You could sell all the stuff you like and toss the body in the river. I won't be coming back. End of dish. Alright, so where's this Angots? Oh, is that Angots? Cool. Let me get you some stew, buddy. Haha, nice. Oh, this is probably where I put it. That's what this is for. Awesome. Hey, buddy. Oh, that I didn't take that harness thingy. Is that for? There we go. I might need that. That is cool. Man, that is a big ass bird. Hey, Angots. Game saved. Alright. New task added. His vest needs changed. Okay, I have a new vest for you. It doesn't work. Isn't that the new vest? Can I? Oh, the clasps first. Okay, gotcha. Alright, so there's one clasp. There's another one. Where's the third one? Down here, right? Oh, there's four of them. Right? Is that? Or that's it. There we go. Oh, it's a mechanical bird. Whoa, badass. Damn! Nice! See you later, Ongot. Sweet. The vest has some numbers on it. Oh, is that the password? For that tablet? Well, let's look at it. 2053. Okay. That's gotta be the password for this. Hey, can I light this candle? I sure can. How about these? Nice. Alright, where's that tablet? It's over here. Yep, I guess that was the password, because before it said you don't know the password, and I imagine I just typed it in. Read entries. Yes. Enter password. 2053. Access granted. I've got a journal now. Thanks, Tabaha. My name is Anabish. I've always lived here because I can't go anywhere else. Grandpa Batjin says lots of people used to live around here, but they all died when the dome blew up. The area has been deserted ever since, aside from myself, Batjin, and Ongots. Ongots has got very powerful claws. He obeyed my father and helped him hunt hares. I don't remember my parents. They died in the explosion as well. When the wind picks up, it gets pretty chilly. You can find refuge from it, but not for long. You can't last long without light. That's why I crafted this transparent layered vest, like in that program about greenhouses. It keeps Ongots warm during the day, and when the night's chill arrives, I put him into another warm vest. I collect and digitize flowers. I look for the prettiest ones and make photocopies of them. Tabaha then takes them into town and sells them. The earnings keep him afloat, while Grandpa and I buy cheese. We've got a new genometer. It measures everything. Flowers, insects, people. It clocked Batjin at 47, and the tree by the gate at 24. Even the stool got measured, though that took a little longer. But when aimed at Ongots or myself, it still shows the same old error. Grandpa says it's all providence. Maybe he's right. I have this dream sometimes. I'm in a strange city. The day is waning. Folks are walking in the distance. There's somebody besides me, but I don't see who. The dream is fleeting, always leaving me with a strange sensation. Like I'm supposed to pass something to somebody, but I can never remember what or to whom. I feel some kind of mix of anxiety and chagrin, and it makes me want to go there, to that town. Grandpa Batjin has died. He wanted to do a transfer after losing his sight and mobility. Tabaha even bought him the equipment, but Grandpa died in his sleep. He was buried at the spot that he requested. Tomorrow marks the 4-year anniversary of Grandpa's funeral, which means I'm already 23. Everything is still the same. I tried leaving again, but no dice. I simply lose consciousness like before. I want to find that town from my dream. Perhaps I'll risk it and do a transfer. Grandpa's got no use for his helmet these days, but I might. If I get lucky, I'll wake up in a new body in Ulaanbaatar. Too bad the genometer won't show my number. I know how dangerous it is. When I look up at the poster over my bed, for some reason I remember my toys. When I was a kid, maybe 5 or so, I had a favorite toy. An odd little space case. Ongots had found it somewhere and brought it to me. Then I saw dark swirls in the field, got scared and stashed the toys away for some reason. And to make sure I didn't forget the hiding place, I came up with a clue. Came out of the yurt, come out of the yurt and fly straight as the crow. On a rock with a snag, look for an arrow. A sorrowful tree will show you the way. A box in the sand will a mystery betray. Okay, this is probably important. Let me read this. Come out of the yurt and fly straight as the crow. All right, so straight out the door. On a rock with a snag, look for an arrow. A sorrowful tree will show you the way, like a weeping willow. A box in the sand will a mystery betray. But now I can't find it. Okay, so... Alright, game saved. That's cool. Let's... Look at that. The game saves when you actually do stuff. Not just read messages at the wall. Alright, so... Straight out of the yurt. Alright, so this way. Uh-huh. Rock with a snag. Look for an arrow. And a sorrowful tree. There's another arrow. Okay. This way. To like dig here? I don't see any further. I mean, I can keep going, I suppose. It really doesn't seem to be much of anything this way. Oh, here we go. There's an arrow this way. Keep going. Doesn't look like there's anything past there. I don't think you'd bury anything here because it'd be underwater. It's at a box with the. And I can keep going across the river. I think I'm going more or less in that same direction. It's a long ways off. I've probably gone too far. What was that noise? I'm just gonna go to that patch of trees, assuming it allows me to go that far. What's up with that sky? Those clouds? Some funky looking clouds. Oh, lets me keep going. Kind of curious to see how far I can go, but who knows, that might be really far. And with the movement speed not being the greatest, it'll take me forever to get back. There's anything here. I want to see what's in that dome. I'm assuming that's the dome that exploded. Doesn't look that exploded to me. Alright. So my ear is there. Let's go back there and start over. Read that entry again. So far, this game is pretty chill. Still not exactly sure what the hell is going on, but it's interesting. I'll give it that. That Amgot's eagle, that was pretty cool. Outside of some really rough looking floor textures at the beginning, kind of an odd choice for where to start you off. At the floor, staring at a wall, is that a shovel? Can I take it? This is a pretty nice looking game, outside of those few really horrible textures. I mean, when you get up really, really close, some of the textures aren't the best, but overall, pretty cool. I guess I can't take that shovel, I won't be digging anything up. Daryl. Substance out of nothing. A curious physical phenomenon is being observed during experiments synchronizing neurochips with DNA copies. A condensate of unknown substance has been forming inside fully airproof sections of the resonating mechanism. Data gleaned from its chemical properties is sure to send shockwaves across the scientific community, researchers claim. The box is wired up. It sure is. Where does that wire go? Oh, that's like an electrical wire, huh? Is that where the battery goes, maybe? Interesting. I have some batteries around here, don't I? There's one. Can I put this battery in that box? I think that's a battery. So that's what these wires are for. I could put batteries in the box and supply power to the yurt if needed. Okay, but it won't let me do it. So that is the right thing, but apparently I don't need to do that now or ever, maybe. Set this battery down. I don't think I need it right now. 38015. If that'll be significant. Custom declaration. Description. Tibetan books. Quantity. 3. Weight. 1600 grams. The correlation of components in potassium varies. In some, the sweet component dominates, while in others, it's bitter. Everything goes back to the HQ. If your HQ is measured at, say, 40, then 40% of the potassium you produce will be sweet, and 60% will be bitter. In short, your HQ equals your sweetness. Ascertaining that number assigned to you by fate is not difficult. Simply contact. Man, there's a lot of stuff to read down here. I'm gonna try to find this box again. Let's see. Come out of the yurt and fly straight as the crow. On a rock with a snag, look for an arrow. A sorrowful tree will show you the way. A box in the sand will a mystery betray. Come out of the yurt and fly straight as the crow. On a rock with a snag, look for an arrow. A sorrowful tree will show you the way. A box in the sand will a mystery betray. Okay. So, come out of the yurt, fly straight as the crow. On a rock with a snag. I'm not sure if it really is a snag, but whatever. An arrow. Okay. Okay, so the arrow points that way. There's another arrow on this tree. Is this the sorrowful tree? So, the arrow's pointing that way. Another arrow around here, wasn't there? So this is it. Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute. There, is that the box in the sand? It is. Oh, very nice. Cool. Glass balls, cold and heavy. Take this? No. Alright. That's like the thing that's... Ooh, game save. Good. That's inside the mechanical woman's head. A little case. The same as the one on the poster. Let me take that. Chewing gum insert. A Mongolian comic book hero slays a dragon. Mini calendar for 2058, Sky Rings. The construction has begun. Alright, well, it's been about a half an hour. The game just saved, so this is probably a good spot to leave off. And next time, I think I'll go and we'll swap out the thing inside Mechanical Woman's head for the one I just picked up, and maybe that'll allow her to operate. I don't know. We'll see. We'll find out next time.